I'll give the floor to the representative of Israel.
Thank you, Madam President. First, I would like to ask Mr. Mansour, when will you address Hamas in your speeches? When you will actually speak about the problem of the Palestinian people? You blame us on everything, but you never mention Hamas. It's a different world that you live. But we know what is the problem. We know why we are sitting here every week, because of Hamas. Madam President, first I must state that the State of Israel is deeply shocked and profoundly saddened by the monstrous kidnapping and murder of Chabad Rabbi Tzvi Kogan this past weekend in the UAE. Israel will use all means available against those responsible for this barbaric act and those who orchestrated it. None will escape justice. I greatly appreciate the cooperation of the UAE in investigating this murder. We will strengthen the ties between us in the face of attempts by the axis of evil to undermine those ties. Also, I would like to mention that we are moving towards a ceasefire with Lebanon. However, at the same time, Hezbollah launched over 500 rockets at millions of Israeli citizens just 24 hours ago, over the last weekend. 500 rockets rained down on innocent families, schools, and homes, leaving millions of civilians scrambling for shelter. Iran's proxy attempts the mass murder of Israeli daily. How many more rockets must be launched before this council faces the reality of who the true aggressors are? Madam President, last week the International Criminal Court has severely weakened our international system, its laws, its norms, and most importantly, its legitimacy, more so than at any other time since the Second World War. It decided to issue arrest warrants against a democratically elected leader of a law-abiding state, Prime Minister Netanyahu, and our former Defense Minister Gallant, for acting in defense of Israel following the largest massacre of Jews since the Holocaust. All the while, Hamas still holds 101 of our people hostage. The very fact that the ICC thought it appropriate to issue arrest warrants for a democratically elected leader alongside an arch terrorist responsible for the October 7 massacre is a mockery, a circus, an insult to the victims of October 7 and the victims of real war crimes committed around the world. The ICC has become the International Circus Court. The legal issues surrounding the warrants are glaring. Israel is not a member of the court, nor a party to the Rome Statute. Yet the ICC shamelessly claims jurisdiction, blatantly bending its mandate to serve the political agendas of its prosecutors. This is not justice. It is diplomatic terrorism. The harm caused to the international legal system will never be repaired. They have loudly and proudly declared that they are not impartial, that they will act based on the biased political agendas of its prosecutors, that they have absolutely no interest in justice. The ICC was established to uphold principles of justice, accountability, and the rule of law. Instead, it has surrendered to the most barbaric terrorist on the face of the planet. It has reduced itself to a political tool used against democracies, while turning a blind eye to the atrocities of the world's worst regimes. Last September, I spoke of the diplomatic terrorism which has been weaponized against the people of Israel. This is that diplomatic terrorism at its most dangerous. It is not about enforcing international law, it is about distorting it. Madam President, esteemed member of this Council, consider the world we now inhabit. Please take a moment to look what's happening. Bashar al-Assad remains in power after the deaths of over 500,000 Syrians during a brutal civil war. Ayatollah Khamenei oversees the Islamic regime in Iran that imprisons, tortures, and murders tens of thousands of its own citizens while funding global terrorism. Conflicts rage across the globe, in Ukraine, Sudan, Afghanistan, and countless others. Yet, the ICC's focus is on the leader of the only democracy in the Middle East, charged with the so-called crime of protecting its people from Hamas, the terrorists who burned families alive, raped women in their homes, and kidnapped over 200 to their terror dungeons. Again, I must remind you all that many of the hostages are citizens of your countries, United States, United Kingdom, France, and Russia. Each of you have citizens held hostage. We are fighting to bring them home. Make no mistake, this is not just an attack on Israel. It is an attack on every nation that values its sovereignty, that dares to act in defense of its people, that seeks to protect its citizens from harm. Today, the target is Israel. Tomorrow, it will be one of you. Diplomatic terrorism spares no one. It poisons every institution it touches, undermines every moral principle, and emboldens those who seek to destroy peace and stability. This is why all decent nations and every moral person in the world must unequivocally reject this injustice. Remaining silent in the face of such distortion of international law is to encourage the end of the global principles we hold dear. It is to abandon the ideals that bind us free and sovereign nations. Yet the international community appears allergic to meaningful action, while the world watches its most sacred institutions lose their legitimacy. We sit here and endlessly debate the slander against Israel. Week after week, we listen to representatives villainizing Israel and rallying their allies against us, not to propose solutions or to build peace, but to manipulate the truth to attack Israel. It was only a matter of time before this poison infected not just the halls of the United Nations, by the supposed purity of international courts. This is the natural evolution of diplomatic terrorism, a campaign that destroys every institution it touches. Mr. Mansour, I listen carefully to your speeches. In all of them, I hear condemnations after condemnations of Israel, justifications of Hamas, and accusations without basis. What I do not hear is any tangible suggestion to improve Palestinian lives. If you truly cared about your own people, you would be here with solutions, with plans for cooperation, with calls for peace. Instead, you come with venom and blame. Because for you, this is not about bettering Palestinian lives, it is about destroying Israeli ones. But the Palestinian delegation is not alone in its hypocrisy. Algeria's actions or inaction speak volumes. While nations across the Arab world take meaningful steps to assist Gazans, Algeria does nothing. No aid, no coordination, just empty condemnations, empty threats, and empty words. After all, this is the same Algeria ranked 164th in economic freedom, 140 out of 146 for gender equality, all with an astonishing 3.6 out of 10 score on the Democracy Index. This is the same Algeria which told its prominent Jewish population, before you expelled them, to choose between, and I quote, the suitcase or the coffin. It would be bad enough if you offered words without any action, but the hypocrisy is unbearable. With the state of human rights and respect for human values in your country, how dare you sit here and posture as you do? Madam President, the ICC's actions and the venom we hear in this chamber are symptoms of a larger disease, the destruction of international norms by diplomatic terrorism, a world where aggressors are emboldened, defenders are villainized, and justice is a tool of convenience in a world on the edge of chaos. Last week, This Council almost made a similar historic mistake with its one-sided ceasefire resolution that abandoned the hostages. The path we are now on sets an extremely dangerous precedent. Diplomatic terrorism must be called out and confronted. We cannot allow the twisting of laws and the distortion of institutions to continue unchecked. Today, the world and the UN marks the International Day for the Elimination of Violence Against Women. Rather than advocating for the release of the 13 women being held by Hamas rapists, we must instead combat diplomatic terrorism. Liri, Karina, Shiri, Agam, Daniela, Judy, Romy, Inbar, Ofra, Neama, Doron, Arbel, and Emily, we will never forget you, never abandon you, and we will never stop fighting for your release. Israel will not be intimidated. We will not be deterred. We will defend our people. We will speak out for the hostages and their loved ones, and we will call out hypocrisy wherever it rears its head. Thank you, Madam President.
I thank the representative of Israel for their statement.